them. Because their wife heard them. Sarah came to Abraham and said, look, I want you to get rid of Hagar. Hagar, get on my nerve. I know I told you to go into her, but now she picking at me. Every time I look at Hagar, she hurts me. You'll find this in William's commentary at the local bookstore. I'm paraphrasing. She said, you get rid of that bondwoman and her child. Y'all don't like me. And it grieved Abraham because he knew Ishmael was his son. Y'all don't like me up in here. But God said, Abraham, do what your wife say. I'll take care of Ishmael. I'll take care of your son. That's your son too. But he's not the promise. See, you got to always protect who the promise come through. Lord, God told Abraham, look, the promise gonna come through Sarah. Not through Hagar. That's your son, but that's not the promise. So you got to protect who the promise come through.
Hey, my God.
The Bible says, I think it's in Thessalonians, a little Friday. He said, if a man don't work, he don't eat.
That's right.
So y'all women always going around feeding a man that ain't got no job. Children, which is the promise.
Right.
Y'all don't like me.
Oh, it's okay.
It's okay. You better get happy with me tonight. You better grin and bear it. Because if I see a frown on your face, I'm speaking. That's right, OJ. You better smile. You see some gold teeth. A mission that the both of you become more and more like one another, and number two, in the process, both becoming more and more like Christ. That when Christ look at you and Centuria, when he look at you and Tanya, my God, when he look at you and Jay, when he look at Jay and Erica, you and Sheila, you and Lynette, you and Maylene. That when, look at it, when God look at y'all, he's supposed to be looking at a picture of him in Christ. Totally one. Look at this. Totally the same, but distinctly different. Oh, it's paradox. How can that be? Michelle, how can that be? Both of y'all, Michelle. Totally the same, but distinctly different. That's how Jesus and God is. Totally one, totally the same, but distinctly different. Marrying somebody else don't take away your individuality. It complements it.
That's right.
You cannot have your own friends. Does that mean you can not like the things, some things he don't like, you might not like? That's positive. Because it put a difference, what I want to say, it puts variety in the marriage. He might like the opera, you might like disco. I that it not become boring. But inwardly, in the spirit, you're one. You're one, but distinctly different.
All right.
Number two.
Uh-huh.
I told you what number one was. Understanding the will of God for your marriage.
Uh-huh.
Number two. Leave the past in the past.
Yes.